Hi, my name is Amanda Rigdon, and I'm one of the applications chemists here at ResTech. I'm here to talk to you today a little bit about the new Pro EZGC Chromatogram Modeler. This is a new piece of software that we have here at ResTech, and we're all very, very excited about it. So what is the Pro EZGC Chromatogram Modeler? In short, it's a revolutionary GC method development tool. With Pro EZGC Chromatogram Modeler, you can develop new methods, optimize existing methods, and add analytes to your existing methods all instantly from the comfort of your computer without ever setting up a GC, purchasing a column, or purchasing standards. So what does all of this do for you? Well, it saves you time and money, of course. What makes the Pro EZGC tool so great? In order to see the value of this tool, we need to take a look at the method development process. So every method development process begins with a compound list. Once we get our compound list, we have to do some basic research on our compounds. What are their boiling points, their solubilities, and look to see if any previous work has been done on these compounds. After we do our research, we have to possibly purchase a standard or a column. At least we have to make a decision on which standard or column to choose. And as we're doing that research, that takes time, and we all know columns and standards cost money. If we do have to order a column and or a standard, we then have to wait for those items to arrive. Once they arrive, we have to set up our GC. If we're setting up an FID GC, it doesn't take very long, but mass specs take a lot longer. After we set up our GC, we do some preliminary runs with our initial separation. Those take time. After our initial separation, we need to do some data analysis and then pretty much refine our separation. We usually don't get a perfect chromatographic method in the very first try. So this is an iterative process. And at the end of this process, hopefully we have succeeded in generating a good workable chromatographic method. But in some cases, we might have chosen the wrong column or, our column doesn't go to a high enough maximum temperature, and we have to go all the way back to the beginning, which is really, really heartbreaking for anybody who's familiar with method development. The beauty of the Pro EZGC Chromatogram Modeler is that all of the time-intensive steps in initial chromatographic method development are eliminated through the use of this powerful software. Instead of spending hours or even days to optimize a separation, we can do this in just minutes without risk and without having to purchase a column or standards. So how does the Pro EZGC Modeler work? The Pro EZGC software is based on well-established rules of solubility. It performs calculations that are based on a database of empirical data that we collect here at ResTech. So using this data, we can predict solubilities of any of the modeled compounds under any oven conditions on a given column on which they're modeled. One thing to note that only compounds that appear in the database can be modeled. That being said, we do have 7,189 compounds modeled currently in 54 libraries. The libraries include volatiles, semi-volatiles, pesticides, all the way through to solvents and drugs. And we're adding new compounds and libraries regularly to keep Pro EZGC up to date and to expand the database. So now for the demo. This is going to be just a very, very quick demonstration of the power of the Pro EZGC Modeler. And in video 2, we'll actually go more in depth on the basic use of the modeler. One thing I'd like to introduce now, though, is the workflow of the modeler. If we take a look at it, it pretty much mirrors the workflow in the development of a chromatographic method. We start with a compound list. We then generate our model. So generating our model is basically like doing our initial runs. We refine our model, which is optimizing our runs, which we would be doing in front of a GC, but we'll see here, we can instantly refine our model. And then once we have a model that we like, then we can purchase any columns or standards that are needed and run it on our system. So here we are at the home screen of the Pro EZGC Chromatogram Modeler. This modeler is a web-based program, and in order to use it, you will have to log into our website. So as I said before, in our workflow, we start with a compound list. So I'm going to just put in a few quick compounds here. So methanol, ethanol, isopropanol. You can type your compounds if you want, or you can paste a list. And for the easiest way of using the modeler, after we have our compound list, we simply hit solve. And what happens now is we have generated a model on the column where these compounds were modeled that has the best separation in the shortest amount of time. So we can see that we have results on two different stationary phases. So we can switch between those two different stationary phases. I kind of like the RTX1. Everybody has those. I have one laying around in the lab. So let's use the RTX1. So let's take a quick look at the model we've generated. We can see this in full screen. We can see details of each of our peaks if we hover over our peaks. We can see the conditions that were used in the model to generate this chromatogram. And then we can even see additional information about our compounds of interest. So if we go back to the parameter input side of the ProEZGC modeler, we can actually go where all the fun is, and that is in the conditions tab. With the modeler, we can change any of our conditions instantly and see the resulting updated chromatogram. In changing to efficiency mode, we tell the modeler to calculate the absolute optimal linear velocity for our column dimensions and starting oven conditions. The change is automatically applied, and the chromatogram is updated. We can switch back to speed mode. We can change to vacuum outlet if we're using mass spectrometry. We can change our carrier gases. We can change our column dimensions if we have, you know, an RTX1 in a different dimension laying around in the lab. The list of column dimensions here are the dimensions that we offer at ResTech. So if you get a model that you like using one of these column dimensions, you can be sure that it will be available for you. And the nicest and easiest thing about the ProEZGC modeler is our ability to automatically optimize our oven program. We have this button here called Refine Oven Program. We simply hit this button until it turns gray. And what this does is it tells the modeler to speed up our oven program to a point where we either hit 30 degrees per minute, because that's the maximum oven ramp rate for a lot of GCs, or we hit this resolution constraint. We'll talk more about resolution constraints in video 3, because there's a lot that we can do with those for mass spec applications. And if we just want to go wild and crazy, we can click the custom button, and we can change anything we want about our parameters. So we can change our flow rate. If we want to speed that up, we see that our model changes. We can change our oven program. Since we're starting at such a low temperature, we can put a pretty aggressive ramp here if we know our maximum ramp rate for our GC. And here, within just a couple of minutes, we have a 3-minute run with a minimum of 2.5 resolution for our closest compounds of interest. And we haven't had to buy any standards. We haven't had to fire up a GC or do any data analysis. So what we have is a very, very good prediction of what our final chromatogram will look like. The one thing that I would like to point out is that this modeler does assume ideal injection conditions. So for compounds like these, if we're using headspace, you know, depending on our injection conditions, these two peaks may be a little bit wider. It's really nice though, because all we have to do, if we want to put a little bit more space in between our peaks, is we can just change our oven program and put a little bit more space between our peaks. So that's the only thing to be mindful of, is that if you're using splitless or headspace injection, the peaks usually at the beginning of your run may be a little bit wider than what the model predicts. As long as we know that, we can put more space in ourselves if we'd like. So once we have a model we like, we can give it a name. hit OK, and save it for future reference. All of our saved chromatograms are saved to the My EZGC tab. Once we have a lot of chromatograms in here, it's very easy to switch back and forth between them, compare and contrast, or just save them for future reference. So that's it for the demo. Make sure to tune in for video 2, which is going to cover the basics of ProEZGC modeler use. What will be covered in video 2 is more information on entering compound lists, because there's a couple of different ways to do this. We'll go over interface details, so far as the model pane that we saw quickly, as well as the conditions pane. And we'll talk a little bit more about refining our model. Thank you for watching. We're really excited about this software, and we hope you are too. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact us.